Sister Philomena, whatever is the matter?
What do you mean?
You've been all morning.
I'm sorry, Augusta. It's just that things have gotten so quiet around here.
Since we're not making wine?
Exactly. That wine won our convent an international award that kept us from having to close its doors. But now...
things are back to normal.
I mean, I know I should be happy mending these holy garments for the church, but I'm not. I just wish things were a little less... dull.
I understand. I mean, I'm sorry I shrieked in mass, but you know, I can't hear the story of Adam and Eve. Snakes, they terrify me.
I know.
And I understand. And I feel the same way.
Oh, good morning, sisters.
Good morning, Reverend Mother.
It looks to be another glorious day. Oh, and I thought Mass was especially good this morning, didn't you? Well, I'll be in the kitchen fixing breakfast for Father Chenille and Paul. Toodaloo. The hills are alive with the sound of music, with songs they have sung for a thousand years. The hills know our heart with the sound.
And that's another thing. Mother Superior, what do you think has gotten into her?
Oh, she's happy, Augusta. Ever since Mother Superior was reunited with her family, she's been as happy as a kitten under a leaky cow.
It's still all so unbelievable. I mean, finding her children, Kate and Paul, after all those years, and then discovering that Father Chenille was her husband she thought had died. It's like a crazy novel.
Or a play.
I'm surprised she hasn't written one. I mean, after all, she goes on about the play she wrote in high school.
Well, I'll gladly take this Reverend Mother over her old self any day of the week. She hasn't yelled at us in months.
True.
Oh, good morning, sisters.
Good morning, George.
So, how are the vineyards? Was this the last harvest of the season?
Oh, yes. I'll be sending the grapes in the town as soon as I get them off the vine. Oh, we have been blessed with more than usual due to the long summer.
Well, wonderful.
But don't worry. I'll remember to set aside a few boxes so you can make the grape juice. I've got a mind like a steel
trap.
Where?
Thank you for setting aside some grapes for us, George.
Say, have either of you seen Kate?
Oh, she took the truck. She was going to pick up some grape boxes. She should be back soon.
Picking up boxes? She shouldn't be doing that.
This is what I said, but she insisted.
Well, when you do see her, please let her know that I'm looking for her.
George and Kate make such a lovely couple. You know, of everything we've sewn, Philomena, Kate's wedding dress, I think, was my favorite.
Well, I liked Sally's, with all that antique lace.
Those were exciting times. So, Philomena, are you thinking what I'm thinking?
I don't know. Are you thinking what it would be like to be married to Cary Grant?
Now I am.
No.
I'm thinking that our pressing room has gone empty for almost a whole year.
Well, that's because we only use it after the final harvest to make the grape juice.
Because Reverend Mother has forbidden us from making wine.
Because alcohol is what separated her and Father Chenille back before their calling. That's why we have to make the wine in secret.
Oh, don't you remember those times? I mean, there we were running around, breaking rules. We made a lot of people happy with that wine.
What are you saying, Augusta?
What if we did it again?
Made wine?
Well, not like before. Only a few bottles and only for fun. I mean, you heard George. We've got a bumper crop, so nobody would have to know. And when it was ready, we could bring it to Mr. Piedmont and sell it and donate the money to the poor.
Oh, Augusta, should we?
No, that's why it's going to be so much fun. Okay, after everybody goes to sleep tonight, we'll sneak into the pressing room and get to work. Right now, let's double time these garments and think of our rest of our plan.
Good morning, sisters.
Oh, Oh, I'm sorry. I almost said Father Ball.
Soon, but not quite yet.
Where's Margaret? Is she preparing breakfast?
Yes, Father Chenille.
Excellent. Could you tell her that Paul and I will be there in just a minute?
Oh, certainly, Father.
And Sister Philomena, perhaps you'd like to join her?
It's Augusta. And no.
You were very good this morning, son. Every part of Mass was handled just right except...
I know.
We simply must get you over your debilitating stage fright so you can give a proper sermon. Last week you stuttered like a broken record until you burst into tears, and today you said three words before passing out. For the first time in history, parishioners are complaining that Mass is too short.
I just can't speak in front of people, Pop. My nerves take over. I stutter or freeze. It's just how it is.
Well, if you're to take over the parish when I retire, you need to get over it immediately.
I want to. More than anything.
Bishop Knight and I worked very hard to convince our new cardinal, Cardinal Blue Jay, to allow me to mentor you in lieu of traditional seminary. Because of our parish's insignificant size and remote location, he's allowing it just this once. How would it be to him if I had to tell him that his courtesy amounted to nothing?
I know, Pop, and I want to take over the parish for you. It's just that ever since Sally left me...
The first time or the second time?
I'm starting to think that maybe I'm not the kind of guy a gal wants to marry.
As your father, I say that's complete hogwash. But as Father Chenille, the priesthood is a lovely calling and will be the right place for you.
Father Chenille, Mother Superior said your breakfast is getting cold.
Coming.
Ah! A ghost! A holy ghost! Augusta! What are you doing under there? Were you spying on Paul and Father Chenille?
Oh, you know I can't help it. You know I've prayed about it, Philomena.
You must stop. Spying will get you into trouble one day. What if you were caught?
Nobody has so far.
That's not the point. Spying will get you into trouble. Now come along. Kate's back with those boxes and she needs help unloading.
I'll go. You stay here and finish these ropes so we don't get behind.
Sister Philomena? Mary! Oh!
Wow.
Sally. Sorry. Old habits.
Disguising myself as a nun was not my finest moment.
What are you doing here? We haven't seen you in 8 months. Ever since you left Paul, that's all.
Also, not my finest moment. I've actually come to talk to Kate.
Oh, she's out back with Sister Augusta and little boxes. Would you like me to go and get her?
Oh, yes, please.
And you want me to tell Paul that you're here? He's just gone in for breakfast.
No. I thought he'd still be at Mass. I cannot let Paul know I'm here. I'm only here in person because y'all still don't have a phone.
Oh, you see, but you...
Please, Sister Philomena, I cannot let Paul Mom here. Or Mother Superior. Or Father Chenille. I can't face any of them after what I've done.
Oh, Sally. Please don't ask that of me. You know I can't lie. Every time I try, all that comes out is,
Well, just don't say anything.
That's a lie of omission.
Don't go through the kitchen. That way you won't see anyone. Please, Sister Philomena, it's very important I talk to Kate.
Oh, all right.
Thank you.
I guess I could go out front and then go around back.
Great.
Oh, Sally, please reconsider and let me tell Paul that you're here.
I know,
Nina!
Oh, it's Mother Superior.
No, I can't let her come here. No.
Philomena, why are you not out helping unload the boxes? You know Kate should not be doing anything so taxi.
Well, Augusta said she would help, and I know it's important to stay on top of our mending.
Priority, sister. You can finish the sewing after the boxes are unloaded. Now go.
What is it, Philomena?
Philomena?
I recognize that stammer. What are you not telling me? I've got eyes on you, Philomena.
You're hiding something and I will find out what it is.
Sister Philomena. Sister Augusta.
George? Is that you?
Who said that?
George, it's me.
God?
Not quite.
Sally!
George, see you, buddy.
We haven't seen each other since you left home the altar. Who knew anyone could run that fast in a wedding dress?
I mean, I didn't have practice that first time I did it.
What were you doing in the high holy closet, Sally?
Oh, I was moving in! Right where I live? So expensive.
Wait, you're going to live in there?
No, George, I'm I came to talk to Kate, and I didn't want anyone to see me, so.
Oh, sorry!
No.
Did you want me to get it for you? I saw her right around back.
I don't mind you seeing me, George. Sister Philomena went to get it for me. You're just one of the nicest guys I know.
Oh. Oh, Sally, have you heard the news? Oh, we found out a few months ago that Kate and I were...
Oh,
we found out that...
Morning, George. Why are you covering your eyes?
No reason. Good morning, Father. Very suspenseful sermon this morning, George. Paul, only three words.
Yes, we were just discussing that.
I can't say that I mind, but it did get me to the vineyards an hour earlier than usual.
What's going on here, George?
What do you mean?
Why do you look so nervous?
Do I?
Like 100-pound turkey on November.
I'm just smiling. Sometimes my nervous face looks just like my smiling face.
Kate and Sister Philomena need help out back, so. Well?
Didn't I hear you say you needed something out of this closet?
Yes, a book. It's on the shelf.
I will get it for you. It's not in there.
What, you didn't even look.
I did, so, Father. You see, I have a very fast eyes. In school, they taught me to speed see.
Speed see.
Yes, it's just like speed reading, only you don't have to read anything.
I'm sure the book's in that shelf.
No book in there. No.
Well, it must have left it at home somewhere. So, go along, George.
Yes, Father.
Are you sure hypnosis is the answer, Pop?
Oh, I swear by it. I used it 10 years ago to get me to stop smoking, and I haven't had a cigarette since. I'm just certain that I can hypnotize you and suppress your stage fright.
Well, I'll try anything at this point.
I am just certain that book is in the shelf. Yes. I'll get it. It's okay. It's okay.
Ow.
I'll just skip through it this afternoon just to remind myself how it's done. Let's see. Ah, here we are. Yes, so you need to be in a relaxed state for the hypnosis to work.
All right.
Yes, it's best to do it right before bedtime. That way the suggestion will continue to sink in. We can do it tonight.
All right.
I'll come up with your trigger word.
What's that?
It's a word that'll help reinforce the hypnosis should ever start to weaken. Meanwhile, you should come up with your welfare word. It's a word to snap you out of it immediately should anything go wrong.
What was your welfare word?
Can't tell you that. You want me to start smoking again? But whatever it is, make sure it's something uncommon. You don't want to be snapped out of your hypnosis accidentally. Now, let's get started next day's sermon. You'll be giving it yourself.
Because they're being forced to shut down. Hundreds of children with nowhere to go.
Well, how horrible, those poor children.
The thing is, though, about this orphanage, it's the same one you and Paul grew up in.
Oh, no. I mean, that was our home for almost 18 years. If it were to close down, I mean, I can't even...
Which is why I'm here, honey. I was thinking you could maybe convince the sisters to donate some of that prize money they won for their wine. I mean, the orphanage needs $5,000. That is a drop in the bucket for all that money they want.
I mean, that money was sent off to Rome months ago. All of it.
Well, I hate to be the bearer of even worse news, but unless that orphanage gets $5,000 in the next 4 weeks, they're done. Anyway, I'm sorry to be the one to tell you this. I figured you'd want to help if you could. So.
I do. Thanks for letting me know.
Yeah. Anyway. All right. I'm gonna get going. I don't want Paul to see me, so I'll see you around.
Is it better, Sally?
What?
Life without Paul?
Oh. Well, no, but it's the life I chose, so.
He really misses you.
It's better this way. I have a job that does not allow time for a husband, and he is taking a job. It does not allow for a wife.
Well, wait, you know he's entering the priesthood?
Yeah, I heard him and Father Chanel talking about it.
Well, Sally, it's not too late. Heck, I was going to be a nun until I met George.
Look, he won't officially be a priest until he's ordained. There's still time.
That ship has sailed, kid.
All my baggage.
See you around.
Mother Superior, it's coming forward. Okay. Well, she hasn't been gone 10 minutes.
Well, she's back. I'm
okay. I'm hiding in the pressing room. No one even there. Okay.
Hey, why are you standing up? The doctor told you to rest as much as possible.
You know, standing's more comfortable than sitting nowadays.
If the Lord had wanted pregnant women to be comfortable, Mary would have been given the presidential suite instead of the state one.
Oh, what are you doing?
It looked like rain, and I left my umbrella in the pressing room sink yesterday to dry.
Well, there isn't even rain in the forecast today.
God is not obligated to tell the weatherman all of his plans, dear.
Don't go in there, Mother, please.
Why not?
Oh, because.
Because why?
Because! I am going into labor!
What?
Yeah! In fact, I think I'm actually having my first contraction right now!
Oh, no! It's so hot early! We've got to get to the doctor!
Good idea! Let's go!
My reading glasses.
What? Quick! Ethics in labor!
Whoa, what? Well, what do we do?
Well, we gotta get her to the doctor immediately!
Okay.
Okay.
Oh, oh no! Let's go! Oh, oh my goodness! Oh, jeez! The pain is so bad! Oh, so bad!
What was that?
that you and I were left at, Paul, they merged.
And now that orphanage is actually in peril. In fact, it's gonna close down completely in a month unless we can raise $5,000.
What?
Yeah, I know. I mean, hundreds of children with no one to take care of them. We have to do something.
Well, do you think we can ask Rome for our money back?
Oh, I guarantee that money's been spent a long time ago.
Well, then we'll have to raise the funds ourselves.
$5,000 in a month?
I have a little in savings. It was going to go towards my honeymoon.
Which one?
And that cave and I won't give all that we have.
Oh, but the twins, you'll need that money.
I can put on a magic show. It wasn't very long that I brought the entire town with my magic act.
And we had to refund every one of those.
Well, there has to be a way, somebody. Let's just think.
Philomene, we were going to make a few bottles of wine for fun. How about we make 100? And we sell them for $50 a piece.
Oh, we've never sold them for anywhere near that price before.
But that was before we won the award. Mr. Piedmont says he's had calls from around the world, and we've never made another bottle. Think of the demand we've created.
Even if we did, fermenting takes time. We'd have to press and bottle all the grits tonight. Not just the ones George set aside for us.
It's the only way. Don't worry, let me worry about the grapes. You need to make sure we have all the supplies we need.
Augusta, it's very risky. What if we were to get caught?
Oh, weren't you the one who said, I want some excitement like the old days? Well, you and I running around making wine, nobody knows. It's exactly like the old days.
Oh, all right. Ah! But only because it'll help save those orphans.
Got it. You can do your play, Margaret. Visions of Bernadette.
Oh, I can't believe you remember. How can you forget? It's all she talks about.
Watching you act is what made me fall in love with you. Your mother was an excellent actress before joining the sisterhood.
Well, I know one shouldn't brag, but I was once called the Greta Garbo of St. Bernard High School.
Yes, in high school, she wrote and produced her very own play. Rave reviews, standing ovations for your performances. You can reprise your most famous role. And I can even throw in a little bit of magic. Abracadabra!
Do you always just keep that up your sleeve?
Exactly for moments like these.
I couldn't.
Could I?
Should I?
Must.
Well, then it's settled. But we'll need two more actors, a male and a female. Kate, you'd be perfect for the role of the Blessed Mother. If you were up to it.
Well, I mean, I'd love any distraction from all this.
And the male role?
Oh, don't look at me, Mother. I'm about to faint just thinking about it.
Well, George, what about you?
I guess I could give it a try.
Oh, and Philomena and I will make props and costumes.
And I'll direct. All right, settled it. We'll begin rehearsals tonight. All right, everybody, hurry along. We have a lot of work to do before we get started. I'll need a copy of the script.
Of France, celebrate my final moments
sweet Bernadette Subaru. I drink once to your life and once to your untimely passing. Though your life is now over, your afterlife in heaven begins. Dear Bernadette, sweet and noble Bernadette.
Abracaluya! And sing.
Mother, I know this is only the first rehearsal, but that was wonderful.
Oh, thank you, Augusta. Yes, Mother. No one dies on stage like you do.
You're not the first to have said that, dear.
Oh, I was wondering if you'd rather doves instead of flowers when you birthed it, guys.
Let's keep the flowers. It's more understated that way.
Oh, in a good way.
Believe me, we need some understatement in this production.
Well, how about when we get a moment I can, you know, saw Bernadette in half, show the crowd how really good of a magician I am.
I think they know how good of a magician you are, Pop. What's up? Just stick with the flowers.
Son, may I have a word?
Of course, Mom.
Yeah. I know you're the director and I'm only an actress, albeit the leading actress, the playwright and the producer. But there's something I think needs to be brought to your attention before it's too late.
What is it?
It's George. He's atrocious.
Oh. Just the first rehearsal, Mother.
A corpse moves more naturally. That table is less wooden. An audience can smell bad acting a mile away. It's a stench they never forget, like a skunk eating rotten sewage at a sewer plant. You have to do the role.
I can't, and it's just the first rehearsal. He'll get better, I'm sure.
We have to sell every single ticket in order to raise $5,000 without one person asking for a refund.
Is that bad?
Let me put it this way. George is as good an actor as your father is a magician.
There's no one else. I certainly can't. And unless you want Pop to play the role of a dignified monk. George is our only actor.
Well, if it must be, it must be. But we'll need a lot of rehearsals. And a miracle.
Great rehearsal, everyone. We'll do it again same time tomorrow night.
Paul, Sister Philomena and I have a question.
Sure, shoot.
In the script, it says that Bernadette Stubaru is 14 years old.
Uh-huh.
14!
That's right.
How? How are we going to make Mother Superior look 14?
Good question. A very good question.
Mother Superior didn't look 14 when she was 14.
Well, just give her some makeup.
The church doesn't allow makeup when done.
Oh. Well, then we'll have to do something else. I'm sure there's a way to make her look 14.
Build a time machine.
George, you did all right in the first rehearsal.
I'm not very good.
You're fine.
I'll get better, I promise. I've never acted before.
I couldn't tell.
Well, it's harder than it looks. I don't know how I'll be able to remember all these lines.
You could practice with Kate.
Well, at least I got the drink and harvested a lot more free time. Hey, she is very good, isn't she?
Mother. He puts a whole lot into it.
Okay, George, it's time to go home.
Good night, everyone.
Good night.
4:30 till morning. We must be getting to bed.
That's right.
Thank you.
Is everybody gone?
Shh.
Yes.
Oh, I'm so glad we... I knew we were just going to get caught with all those grapes after dinner.
Oh, thank goodness we did it. What did you tell George?
Well, I told George that somebody had come and picked him up, and so he didn't have to take him into town tomorrow, which is the truth.
Oh, I feel bad taking advantage of George's trust.
Oh, it's for the greater good. Now, you get in there and wash the bottles, and I'll go get the labels that we made.
Okay.
Are you sure we have to do this here, Pop?
Yes, we need complete quiet,
all right?
Now, the little furnace at home bangs away all night. We'll be in and out of no time. Just keep your voice down, okay? Now, sit down. You have
a
trigger
word. Yeah. My mouth will throw words.
All right, good. Now, let's begin. Take a deep breath in. Breathe out, relax. Take a deep breath in and out. In and out. Now, look at this coin. Watch it go round and round and round. I want you to focus on what your greatest fear is. Focus on what gives you the greatest anxiety. In your mind's eye, I want you to see what it is you fear. Do you see it? Good. Now, speak what you fear the most. Public speaking.
Snakes!
My fear now is disappearing, slowly but surely disappearing, getting smaller and smaller and smaller, until it's gone! Should it ever return, when you hear the word focus, it will disappear again. Focus.
Focus.
But, should you ever hear the word... Oh, I really need my reading glasses. Silly! You will return as you were once before. Silly. Now, when I snap my fingers, you will feel refreshed and have no memory of this at all. 3, 2, 1. How do you feel?
Fine. Did it work?
We'll find out this Sunday.
It's just a small spill.
Well, go get a blue towel so it won't show. The last thing we need is evidence of what we're up to.
All right.
Well, I guess I'll walk down to his house and see if he can take me.
Nonsense! You're soaking wet! Here, use this to dry off, and I'll go get the keys and take you home.
Oh, Philomena. But you know what? It has to be done tonight.
Are you two making wine again?
You are! Why else would you be in the pressing room in the middle of the night? Wow! Something's never changed! Incredible!
Philomena, is that you?
Couldn't we just pull a rope from the high holy closet and use that?
No, those are russet, not chocolate.
Ah, my mistake.
I told you he wouldn't be able to tell the difference.
So many on his mind.
Oh, and how many 100-year-old monks are coming to our show?
And this must be the gown for the Blessed Mother.
Yes, we've had to let the seams out twice. Okay. Kate keeps gaining weight.
But we made another one, an extra size larger, in case she walked into this one.
Excellent thinking, ladies. And since Bernadette was a nun later in life, Mother Superior could just wear her own vestments.
Have you given any more thought about how we might make her look younger?
Maybe different glasses. Speaking of her, how is she today?
Oh, the same. Mother Superior truly believes that she had a vision from the Blessed Mother who came to her with a special message. She's been in her room praying for another vision ever since.
She says she's been chosen, but she doesn't know for what.
Well, whatever she saw that night, I hope she gets back to normal soon. She's been sleeping less and less since it happened. Anyway, props. I think we have everything we need, except for the prop, the wine the monk drinks.
Well, we're going to use grape juice. We figured we can let George use the bottle for rehearsals, and we won't put the grape juice in until the performance. We don't want anything to confuse poor George.
Thank you again, ladies. With all the hard work you've done, I don't know how I could have done this without you.
Augusta, about that juice.
Don't worry. After we made our wine, there were two boxes of grapes left. So I went in there today, and I pressed them, just pressed. And I put the grape juice in bottles with white labels, and I put the you-know-what in bottles with red labels.
Okay, grape juice, white labels, red labels, wine.
Exactly, and just in case, I went and hid all of the red label bottles.
Oh, how do they look?
Oh, as far as I can tell, they're gonna be here in the nick of time.
Oh, would it be?
Oh,
Hey, Papa.
Oh. I've been working on a new trick all day. I thought it'd be a more interesting way to make the Blessed Mother appear.
More interesting how?
Like this! Abracaluia!
Oh, sorry. I saw these in the kitchen and they looked so good.
My goodness, these cravings. They come out of nowhere.
Hey, listen, I'll think about it, Pop. But for now, could we...
Yeah, I know. Just stick to the flowers.
Does anyone have a dill pickle?
Oh, I have a pickle!
Oh, great! Thanks!
Wow.
Or a pork roast!
Just trying my luck. Okay.
I saw Mr. and Mrs. Rick at the market. They were highly complimentary of your sermon this morning.
Well, thanks to you. That hypnosis seems to have worked 2 weeks in a row now.
Maybe it's time we invited Cardinal Lujay so he can observe you so he can be ordained.
Not until after the show is over, Pop. One big event at a time.
Or a watermelon! Does anyone have a watermelon?
I have a watermelon!
Oh, great!
Don't encourage her. She's carrying a watermelon under that dress.
All right, everyone. Tonight's our deadline to be off book, okay? I'm gonna be following along in the script, just in case anyone needs prompting, but whatever happens, let's just have fun and break a leg. Where's George?
Sorry, I was in the kitchen running my lines. Father Chenille, did your trick work?
No, not at all.
Oh, that was my fault. I took a detour.
And has anyone seen Mother Superior?
Here, George, let me help you.
I think
it's just
clear me.
The last time I saw her,
but
praying for another pigeon.
Mother,
come on
now.
George, George. If you didn't have your food.
See, I think. Can you give me some butter for my bowl?
Not a waitress, dear.
Wait, George.
All right. Everyone, just get in places. We're about to start. Just Mother, where's that vibrant young word of death?
I am, so I'm
home. Ah, you look like you hardly slept.
Well, I tried, but I come out here hoping to have another visit.
But you need to get some sleep. I'm worried about you.
What's right, Margaret?
And miss another visit from the Blessed Mother? Never, never. Now let's get on with the show. As soon as we're finished with rehearsal, as soon as she can come back.
All right. For real this time, guys. There's a music, a music fades, and go lights, and...
Why, hello there! What a mighty fine-looking crowd!
Pop, you're doing that thing with your voice again.
What thing?
Just use your normal voice.
What a mighty fine-looking crowd! And you, ma'am, well, you're as beautiful as a bouquet of spring flowers. No need to be in fear there. No, that wasn't a miracle you just saw. It was a trick, an expertly executed magic trick by one of the greatest magicians the world has ever known. Available for birthday parties and other celebrations at a reasonable price.
Take to the script, Pop.
Very few people have seen a miracle, but I know someone that not only encountered one, but 18 of them. I'm talking about the sprightly, the spirited young girl, 14-year-old, Bernadette Subaru!
La 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 la, hear me sing my song.
Bernadette's supposed to be skipping in and singing?
In all my years of life, 14 years, I have never had a carrying on a crazy world. Oh, the poverty stricken and sickly, I know there was a great and wonderful plan for my life. I am filled with soul and life. I am youth. Oh! Why not you see Friendly Monk from next door? Hello, Friendly Monk.
Hello there.
If you need your line, George, just say a line.
Line?
Right.
Line?
Yeah, that's right.
No! Line?
Oh! Bernadette!
Hello there, Bernadette! How lovely to see... A line?
You!
Line?
Where are you going?
wine.
Now you drink.
Now you drink.
No, George, just drink.
Oh. Just drink.
No, George, you're supposed to drink from the bottle.
There's nothing in it.
I know, it's a prop, just mind.
Okay.
No, George, it's a prop. I want you to use the bottle as if they... Never mind.
Oh, why look, it's the grotto Massa Bien. I am going to dip my toes in the water. Just a little.
To believe that the Blessed Mother is with child. Twins, no less. But it's another thing to ask them to believe that she can't stop eating for 10 seconds! I'm sorry, everybody. I know we're all trying our best here, but if this is our best, it's not good enough! I mean, with 1 week to go, I have to cancel the show.
Whoa.
I mean, it's impossible. I mean, if you could just see how behind we are, we just can't do it. Not unless there was some heavenly sign, some grand sign from above telling us to go on with the show.
That the Blessed Mother came and appeared to us all.
Well, it was a miracle.
And then she disappeared. Poof, not another word.
She didn't need to. The Blessed Mother told us everything she needed to.
Well, miracle or not, the play is in a few hours and it's no better than it was a week ago. George can hardly get through his lines. And Mother Superior can't stay awake. And Kate says two lines and then needs a 5-course dinner.
Praise be, we have wine to sell. And we'll need to sell every single bottle now. We'll need that money now more than ever.
Shouldn't be a problem. Mr. Piedmont has said that the demand has been so great, he's opening his store early. He guarantees that we'll sell every bottle and have that money by Monday. And we'll sneak it into the ticket money. No one will have any idea.
How did you get the cases of wine to him?
George brought them.
You told George what we did?
No. George thought he was bringing grape juice for the poor.
Well, ladies, he has finally arrived. Are all the props set?
Well, everyone has their costumes, and yes, the props are almost all set.
Okay, okay, excellent, excellent.
Oh, are you nervous?
Just opening jitters. There's a lot riding on this one performance. Where is everybody?
Well, George is in the kitchen running lines, and
Kay is around here somewhere.
Emptying the pantry, no doubt.
And Mother Superior is in her room.
Napping?
Praying.
Oh. I told her to get some sleep. She'll be in no condition to perform.
She's been drinking coffee to stay awake all day.
She doesn't need caffeine. She needs rest.
Well, she's afraid she'll miss another vision from the Blessed Mother since she's already come twice.
If indeed that's who it was.
Well, what do you mean?
We saw someone. Whether it was the Blessed Mother or not, I have my doubts.
Well, who else could it be? We all saw the light. We heard angels singing.
Anyway, the audience is going to arrive in about an hour. We need to set up the chairs and the rest of the stage.
Well, all right. Sister Augusta and I will take our sewing to our room and see if we can get Mother Superior to take a nap.
Good luck with that.
Need a hand?
Yes, actually. That would be... Sal! What are you... I didn't think,
Catechism, Gatchertown?
What are you doing here?
Oh, well, I heard about the show and why you were doing it.
The audience isn't going to come for 2 hours.
I know. I came to help.
With what?
I don't know. Don't you need anyone backstage or doing sound cues or anything?
I got a hand.
Eight months no see. What you been up to?
I'm still the paper.
I suspected.
Ooh, only I'm not a reporter anymore. The chief stepped down, and for some crazy reason, the publisher chose me to replace him.
I've been editor for 6 months.
Congratulations. I didn't know.
Do you miss it, being a reporter?
I miss the job. I don't miss the long hours, the stress, but...
People?
No, I miss them most of all. You look good, Sal.
Tell me something I don't know. You look good too, Paul.
A simple laugh agrees with me.
Oh, I heard you're up for a new job?
Yeah, Pop's been trying to retire for a while now, and there wasn't anybody to take his place.
Until now?
Believe me, it's not where I saw myself either, but... I think it's the right thing to do.
For you? Or for him? Paul, you hate public speaking.
Yeah, well, I've changed, Sally.
Oh. Well, that's too bad. I always like the old you.
Just not enough.
No, Paul. Too much. I got scared.
We talked about this before, the first time you got cold feet.
The first time I ran off because I wanted to break that story about the Dillon boys. This time it was different.
Not for me, Sally. I was still on an altar and in a tux watching you run away. For me, it was exactly the same.
And I'm sorry about that, okay? I am.
Look, I know you didn't come here to hash out the past. Why are you here?
I told you. I came to help. When I heard about that orphanage, I had the paper run full page ads, free of charge. I wanted you to sell out.
That's really nice of you, Sally. That means that... You see, that's not fair. The way you do things like that. You make me remember how much I...
How much you what?
I gotta go, Sally. It was nice seeing you.
No, but Paul, but...
Where is Paul rushing off to?
Yeah,
geez. Oh, good. Oh, wow.
Oh my gosh. when are you due? Like 6 months ago? Jeez. Hey, George, are you ready for your big stage debut?
I hope so.
He's really nervous about his lines. He's been so focused on them, he's neglected all his chores.
Aw.
You'll be okay, George. You're going to be great. I have faith in you.
Well, thank you, Sally.
Yeah.
That really does mean a lot.
You came awfully early. Well, I came to help.
I know.
Well, maybe there's something you can do backstage. What did Paul say?
I'm like the cannibal who came late to dinner. He gave me the cold shoulder. Just give me a time. I don't know why I was expecting anything more. Just that ever since I figured out that he was becoming a priest, I've just thought and thinking about what could have been.
Oh, girl can be. I don't think so, but I like when you say that.
Hey, why don't you go see if Paul needs any help putting out chairs or hanging up curtains?
Okay.
Now, please, girls. I have only ever known you to be a focused, confident, motivated woman. I've never seen you not go after something that you want.
What makes this so different?
Because Paul is different.
It's obvious you still love him, and he definitely loves you.
I'm not so sure about that.
Look.
Look. You left him, okay? I mean, his feelings for you haven't changed. He's just stuffed them away. Tell him how you feel and figure out the rest later.
Easier said than done. Get out, Sally.
Love? It's the only thing easier done than said.
Hey, it's time!
Oh, man.
needed a little something to tide me over.
Oh, oh, jeez. It's like the audition for the Rockettes in there.
Are you sure you could do the show, Kate?
Of course, George. I mean, we have to do it.
Well, after tonight, I want you to take it easy.
Oh, George, I mean...
No arguments. We'll look after you for a while. Is this weird, a monk kissing a blessed mother?
A little help here. I found her asleep in her room, praying on her knees.
Mother, what are you doing? We're in places.
I'm fine, son.
Oh, sister, go splash cold water on her face. Do whatever you can to keep her awake. Everybody else, we'll start the moment she gets back.
Kate, look at me, I'm trembling.
George?
What if I forget my lines?
I gave Sally a script. She's going to be upstairs in case anyone needs a play.
Okay, you're always looking out for me.
You can tell I love you, George.
Use this time to check your props. Approved props.
No, Sister Philomena forgot to fill my bottle.
I'm helping Mother Superior right now. Just go get some juice from the kitchen.
Oh, it's bringing me back something to nibble on.
I'm here, everybody. Wow. I had to fight my way through that crowd. Oh, looks like those ads worked too well.
Sally, what are you doing backstage?
I asked her to help, Paul. Yeah. She's going to be on book in case anyone needs a line.
I guess that's not a bad idea.
You got the script, honey?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, what is she doing here?
Pop, being nice. Sally's going to help with the show.
Hello, Father Schmiel. It's good to see you again.
Oh, are you staying for the entire performance, or is there somewhere you have to run off to?
Is this the time? Mom's going to be out any moment now. Just take places. And put away that case!
Sorry about that. He actually really likes you. He's just disappointed things didn't work out between us.
I get it. I'm disappointed myself. Disappointed in myself.
Sally?
I made a huge mistake, Paul. I miss you. Every single day.
Then why did you leave?
It won't make sense.
Try me.
You're practically perfect, Paul. You've got this great family. Your father, your mother, your sister who used to be a sister, and you've got great friends, like George. And you do things for others, not because you'll get something out of it, but because it's the right thing to do. I'm not like that. I'm selfish. I'm suspicious. I have a hard time letting people in. I don't even have any friends. Not real friends, just coworkers who treat me like one of the guys. But sometimes a girl doesn't want to be one of the guys. Sometimes she just wants to be a girl.
Oh, Sally.
Paul. She wakes up and says, if you mind, then don't go back to sleep. We tried everything. Coffee, cold water. What do we do?
I knew this would happen. I knew she would crash, but why did it have to happen tonight?
It's the only way we could think of. First, we didn't want the audience to see her eyes were closed, and then we had to make her look 14.
Well, I couldn't find any juice in the kitchen, but then I remembered that Sister Augusta gave me about 100 bottles of juice this morning. They were still in the back of my truck.
You forgot to deliver the bottles?
I meant to, but. Father Schneel needed help finding his magic case, and Paul needed help finding enough chairs, and, well, I'll use this one tonight, but I'll bring the rest into town tomorrow.
Oh, he's here. I can't believe it.
Cool, Pop.
Cardinal Blue Jay, he's sitting in second row.
Really?
Hi.
Why is he in town?
I have no idea.
Pop.
Unless I invited him to watch you give your sermon Sunday so you can be ordained.
Oh, we agreed to not do that until after the show was over.
The show will be over tonight.
No!
Oh, don't be silly. It'll be fine. All you need to do is just focus. Paul, focus.
All right, everybody, places for the top of the show.
Can you see
that
security?
Look over there, but look out the bottom.
What did you do to my glasses?
Okay, whatever happens, just keep going, all right? There's music.
What? Why, hello there! What a mighty fine-looking crowd! And you, Cardinal Blue Jay, while you are just as handsome as a, if I can get it right, a bouquet of spring flowers. No, that wasn't a miracle you just saw. That was a trick, an expertly executed magic trick by the father of one of the greatest, soon to be priests, the world has ever known.
Stop improvising, Pop.
Very few people have seen a miracle, but I know someone that helped in a miracle, but 18 of them. I'm talking about the sprightly, the spirited young girl, 14-year-old, Bernadette Subaru!
Sam, you could take her place.
No.
I'm no actress.
No call.
No.
You did radio for years. It's basically the same thing. No. Sisters, make sure to get the right thing from the Holy Closet.
Radio is acting. It's reading dramatically. No, I don't know the lines.
We can use your script. We'll just hide it in the pocket.
The very next day.
she was told. Drink from the grotto. She bathed in the grotto. And the Blessed Mother returned once more.
Oh, oh! Oh, look, it's coming! What on the floor?
Don't worry about it. It's fine. It's... Don't.
I'm so glad we have a star. Just to have a laugh or a sing a song. It seems we just get stuck. And before you know it, comes the time we have to stay. So
dear Mother Death, you have done as I've asked.
But giving a sermon is one thing. But I think I can't be.
All right,
you'll
be fine, son. You'll be fine. All you have to do is just focus, Paul. Focus.
Let's do this. George, I can use your help. He's out of the
way. Wait.
Oh, yeah. Just give me the rope. That's... Wait, that's
act, act like it's the right color.
All right.
Paul. How old do you know the script?
Enough to get by.
Alright. Sister Gussa?
Got a word.
Look, Paul, we're gonna cut our losses. We'll just skip to the final scene, okay? It'll be great.
That's fine.
Okay. Okay.
Thank you.
What?
For being here when I needed you the most.
Of course, Paul. Don't be silly. Dear Monk, this morning, Blessed Mother told me to plant crops by the grotto, and she shall nurture them to maturity, and we shall have food plentiful in our village once more.
Burn it!
It's going on. I thought you said you were over your stage fright.
Burn it to the grotto.
To her for the 17th time.
No, what's the plan? I don't know any of these lines.
I don't know, just move your mouth and gesture a lot.
Okay.
Dear Bernadette, sweet Bernadette, lovely Bernadette, you shall see me but once more. But why, Blessed Mother? There are others who need my help. But you must prove your devotion to me one final time. Yes, I will do anything you say, Blessed Mother. Live your life in service. Help others as I have helped you. Do this to honor me. I will do whatever you say, Blessed Mother. You said I will see you but one last time. When will that be? Tomorrow? Not as soon as that. But you will indeed see me one final time, Bernadette Subaru. And when you do, you shall be happy. So very happy.
Oh, wait! One more scene to go!
Tom. I can win them over. Just one final trick, okay? I know I can do it.
I call Cleopatra's card, okay? I really don't think that this is a good idea.
I'm just gonna take this saw and this deck of cards and I'm gonna saw them in half. And then I'm gonna take each snake and tape it to half of each of the deck. And then I'm gonna put them all in a pile and then
don't
I'm gonna wave my hands up for the entire thing.
It's your cue.
It's gonna work fine, okay? Just hold these.
Wait, don't be silly, Pop.
Snakes!
Don't One final trick. One thing, and nothing with snakes.
Hello, if I can have a participant in the crowd. You, ma'am, you look like a very sprightly person to help me out with this. If you could just please just pick a card. Any card, I will not look at the deck at all. Yeah, show the crowd so that they may see it. Fantastic! And now I use this special magical deck of cards. You can place it anywhere in the deck. I won't look at it at all. Yes, fantastic, yes, fantastic. You shuffle the cards. Oh, presumably, and I will put them in here, and I will just not even be able to see the cards at all. It will be a fantastic trick. I will just throw them in the air, and everything is going to be wonderful. Just wonderful, and I just have to say the magical words of this entire thing. Bernadette joined the Sisters of Charity, where she spent her years in the infirmary embroidering vestments, sickly all her days. Tuberculosis opened the gates of heaven to her.
It is now that I celebrate my final moments here on Earth. I have had 17 visions of the Blessed Mother. And now I see her one final time. Take me, dear mother. Take your sweet, innocent, beautiful Bernadette home.
Sweet, sweet Bernadette Subaru. Though your life is now over, your afterlife in heaven begins. Dear Bernadette, sweet and noble Bernadette. Abracadabra!
Deceit?
I guess so.
We're sorry, Reverend Mother.
But it was worth it, calls. We would have made all the money we needed if all those bottles wouldn't have broken.
I'll deal with you two later.
And the second time.
Well, someone took the battery out of my car. So I bought a new one and came back with a mechanic to install it. We came at night so no one would see us. And I popped my head in right as Paul was talking about canceling the show. I couldn't let him give up on those orphans. So I started talking. At the same time my car started, with the radio blaring and the headlights on, I wasn't pretending to be the blessed mother. Well, not that time. And I guess once I realized that that's who you thought I was, I didn't exactly correct you. How was I supposed to know you'd lose sleep for weeks? I can't figure out who would take the battery out of my car.
Oh, well, I might be able to explain that.
George!
Oh, Kate!
Hello, oh, ladies!
They're beautiful!
This is Evelyn. And this is her brother, Adam.
Oh, whoa. Adam and Eve?
I took the battery out of your car, Sally.
What? You? George, well, why?
Well, you hadn't come around at all since you left. You hadn't seen Paul. And I knew his feelings for you, and I suspected yours for him. I just wanted you to stay a little longer to see if you and Paul still... Okay, it wasn't the best plan, but it worked. You're back.
I guess. But I'm sending you the bill for my car battery.
May I present to you Father Paul?
Oh.
Not yet. The coronation isn't for another hour.
He was superb this morning. Both sermons knocked him right out of the park.
Thanks to the hypnosis.
Well, oh, congratulations.
Yes, we're really proud of you, Paul.
Babies!
Oh, yeah, this is Evelyn, and this is Adam.
Adam and Eve?
That's what I said!
Congratulations to you, Grandmother Superior.
And the same to you, Grandfather Chenille.
Hey, tell him the good news, Pop. Ah, Cardinal Blue Jay loved the play.
Oh, really? Oh,
yeah, it turns out he didn't speak English.
Oh, my God.
But he liked it so much, he said he will match dollar for dollar what we make.
Oh, wow. That's great. It's awesome.
Let me go get the proceeds and see how much we pay.
Peace out. I just wanted to say thanks for everything, you know? Whenever I feel like I can't do anything, you make me feel like I can do everything.
Oh, well, you can, Paul. I mean, gosh, you're about to become a priest.
Yeah.
Dad, are you crying?
It's just so precious, my precious grandparents.
Oh, Lord, I knew your father would melt. He's always loved babies.
Aw, Dad.
Well, shall we?
Of course. Sally, one more thing.
Listen, I have a confession to make.
Whoa, don't you need a priest for that?
Pop hypnotized me so I could get over my fear of public speaking.
Oh, based on your performance last night, he's as good a hypnotizer as he is a magician. Paul, you froze colder than a polar bear. Eating a snow cone at Santa's workshop.
Yeah, well, there's a word that's supposed to snap me out of it. Pop asked me to say something that I don't hear very often.
Oh, so that's it. After the show, we kept going on and on about someone saying the word silly.
Yeah, but silly wasn't the word. He didn't have his reading glasses on. I think he misread it.
Oh, what was the word?
Sally.
Oh.
It's just, well, we haven't seen you for a while. I mean, none of us have. And I also having trouble getting over you. And...
No, I understand.
No, Sally, you don't. Whenever you left, I thought I'd never see you again. I thought we could never be together, but now you're back and... I love you, Sally. I always have. But I need to know once and for all. Do you still love me?
I do!
We can make it work this time, not let your job get in the way.
It's not my job. I'm worried about Paul.
Oh, yeah.
Look, it's too late. Your father's retiring and moving, but if things were different, I know we can make it work. Because, well, you're the star of my show.
Well, do we have a tally?
I've got the final tally right here.
Oh, awesome.
Well, there's the money that Paul and Georgie Kate gave, and considering the matching funds from Cardinal Blue Jay, and all the tickets that were sold, and all the refunds we had to give, the grand total is...
Match?
I'm afraid so.
Paul. It's okay, Kate. We did the best we could.
Hey! The money not. It's not due until tomorrow when the bank opens. What if we did another show tonight? Or not.
Look, everybody. We did our best, and I'm proud of us for that.
I'll get it.
Whoa. What was that?
The phone in the kitchen.
Since when do you have a phone in the kitchen?
We got it about 3 months ago. I guess it's lucky you didn't know, or you might not have come. Just kind of like it's lucky someone called you about the orphanage. Dad, it'll be okay.
No, it's not that. I can't leave. No, but my precious grandbabies.
Oh, Lawrence.
Copper, are you saying you don't want to retire anymore?
No. No, but I will. It's your turn now.
But what if I told you I didn't want to be a priest?
But your nation.
Well, cancel
it. Cardinal Blue Jay flew all this way to give the ceremony.
We'll give him a different ceremony to conduct instead. Sally Ann Andrews! No one makes me crazier than you. You're the first thing I think about in the morning, the last thing I think about at night. I never want the fun we have to end. People say that good things come to those who wait. Well, I've been waiting for a very, very, very long time. So will you do me the honor of finally becoming my wife?
Yes, the thousand times yes!
Abracaluia! You never know when you're going to lose. Welcome to the family.
It's a miracle!
What is it, Philomena?
Well, that was Mr. Peabody on the phone. And he came to the show last night, and afterwards he approached me, and I told him about all of the wine bottles that had fallen off the back of the truck and how most of them broke. He really had one left. But anyway, he took that final bottle to his shop this morning, and there was a bidding war. It sold for $5,000! That means we can not only save the orphanage, but we can donate an extra $3,000!
The orphanage is great! Our wine is saved the day.
Soon to be Mrs. Billings. What do you think about all this?
I think it's swell, Mr. Billings. Just swell.
Thank you.
you get down on your knees, they'll win your rosaries. Bow your head with great respect and
yes, we need this back.